I've selected this image from Namya Phal, which is the geothermic area of Mivan. And it is a very, very long exposure. This is 15 minutes at f5.6 on the lens. The actual image quality underlying is really, really good, but it almost looks like daylight. And so it is going to need a little bit of work to create the right kind of mood. And the first thing I'm going to do is use the high dynamic range tool and pull the highlights back. And that will just allow me to see where the moonlight at the very top is damaging the image, if it is, and I'll go from there. White balance is a really important part of any landscape photography process, and unfortunately doesn't lend itself well to any formula. You have to evaluate the colors based on your own memory and experience rather than necessarily, say, using a gray card, which can be done in other types of photography. And here I'm probably going to need a little bit more magenta, I think, to get it to look right. And I'll just move the Kelvin scale as well and see if, no, in fact, this image probably needs to be quite cool, just with a little bit of warmth in the lights at the bottom. These formations are the geothermic vents in the area, and we had a car headlight illuminating them from the back and behind, and it gives them quite a mysterious quality. But the color balance is something that is still a matter of personal taste. I quite often use saturation and contrast changes, and they are really, really important in setting the tone and the feeling of any image. With an image like this, it's important not to overdo it, because that could potentially really take some of the mystery out of it. So for me, it's always a matter of balance. The tool that I would really want to use here is probably the vignetting tool, because the lens actually renders the image, the scene, so perfectly it's almost too flat, because it's a very, very high quality lens, the 55mm Schneider Kreuznach. But if I use the vignetting tool, I can darken the corners quite subtly, and that actually really helps the mood. I don't want to really notice the vignetting, but just holding those edges really adds something and a feeling of light to the image. It's really important with all photographs to control the contrast and saturation in a way that is consistent with your feelings and memories of the event. And this particular shoot had, for me, a great sense of mystery and the feeling of the nighttime about it. In order to make it look right, I'm probably going to have to reduce the exposure a little bit more, just to give more of a sense of night. And now, I think I can afford to increase the contrast somewhat and bring out the detail of the smoke leaving the fumaroles. And now it's pretty close. The saturation tool in Capture One is really good, because it enables you to increase color saturation, and the way that it works, it actually detects the less saturated colors and helps to pull them up. So it's possible to apply quite a degree of additional saturation without it looking unnatural. And I often use a preset of around 15 plus points of saturation. And as you can see from this example, that does help to emphasize the colors without making them look strange. And of course, color is a really, really important part of what brings a photograph like this to life. Here, the blues and the oranges are now nicely balanced, which shows that the white balance itself is also correct. And I think this is nearly ready. Finally, I would like to show you the very, very quick and easy 100% tool in Capture One. Double click with the hand, and that takes us into the image. And for me, this is a really extraordinary breakthrough, because I'm looking at a 15-minute exposure here. The lens is set at 5.6. The image is perfectly sharp. Fine detail is extraordinary. I've applied no additional capture sharpening at all, and there's no noise at all, even in the deepest shadows. It's exciting, but it means I may have to do a lot more work in the future doing night photography, and I already work hard enough, so I'm not sure if this is an advance I'm really happy about. If we look at the overall amount of information on this image, go to full screen, I can see that there are things in it I perhaps feel aren't really essential to the main message of the picture, which is around the mountains and the fumaroles. So, especially because the moonlight is somewhat intrusive, I'm intending to crop the top using Capture One's crop tool, which is very, very simple and straightforward to use, and also the bottom where there's a large area of snowfield that's not working particularly well. And if I then click on the hand tool, it'll take me to how the image is seen and rendered now. And the beauty of using a high resolution camera is that I don't have to worry with cropping. I can crop probably up to 50% without any fear that print quality will suffer. So if I'm processing an image for output in Capture One, I have a variety of ways of doing it. And one of the nicest features is that you can create your own recipes, as many as you like. And those recipes, most photographers will find, are ones that they use on a regular basis. So if we create a process recipe, we open up the process folder within the process directory here. So if I was creating an image for print, I want a TIFF rather than a JPEG, or I could in fact create a PSD. This is a new feature of Capture One 7. But for this example, I'm going to use a TIFF. I use a 16-bit output, no compression, Adobe 1998. I personally use a resolution of 360 because that is the preferred resolution for my printer. Fixed scale, 100% means that it is a native file. And if I want to open it when I finish, I don't, but you can, if you wish, you can have it to open in Photoshop, for example.